Hey everybody, welcome back to the Metal Gear Recollection. This is part 17, probably the finale of Metal Gear Solid Peace Walker. God, it's been a while since we fucking done one of these. Say hi, Tony.
Hi, I farted.
Oh, that's horrifying. Speaking of a horrifying fart, these motherfuckers are like, well, there's this nuke. Let's just arm it and load it onto our giant walking fucking tank. So here we are where we start. Well, we've seen it for a while, but here we are. These guys are going fully off the fucking deep end and acting like it's normal. They're fucking arming a nuke and they're putting it on their giant walking anime tank.
Fuck. God damn it. Are you serious with this bullshit?
You're looking at it.
So to prevent them from being nuked, they have to arm themselves with a nuke.
Yeah.
That's basically what happened. What a crock of shit.
Yeah, think about how crazy is this shit.
It's fucking stupid.
It's fucking crazy.
No, it's stupid.
Okay, I agree. But these are clearly fucking crazy people, so there you go. So just so everybody knows, this is kind of, this is going to be kind of a different format from what we normally do here, because this video,
boom!
This part we're watching here is actually, wasn't that sexy? This is actually a montage of all of Act 5, and we're going to stop the montage and go back to gameplay right at the finale. But Act 5 kind of is a fucking mess, because you beat the game, right? You beat Peace Walker.
But you haven't really beaten.
You get the credits and everything and blah, blah, blah. And then the game continues. Go ahead.
But you really haven't beaten it.
You really haven't beaten it because you haven't reached the actual finale. Kojima, in his past couple, or in his last two games, this one and the Phantom Pain, has put two finales in his games. Here, let me take a quick swig of water here.
You're disgusted.
So
zoom in on that face.
So the end of this game. the end of this game, Act 5. Is a collection. It's just you doing the side missions and then a little bit of story happening. And so I've collected all the story into like 12 minutes here and, you know, thrown a little gameplay in there to show kind of the progression. But yeah. The whole idea at this point is you've beaten Peace Walker, you have a nuke, you have this guy, you know, you have the KGB guy Zadornov in your fucking, in your brig, and he keeps getting out. And he gets out a total of 7 fucking times he disappears. So you have to do 7 missions in order to progress the story in Act 5. And that's all you get. That's all you get is you do a couple missions. Hey, Zadornov's escaped again. God damn it, Kaz, you fucking piece of shit. We're gonna hire a fucking Korean guy instead of you fucking half-Japanese shit faggot ass bitch. 7 times. And the 7th one is what triggers the finale. Yeah. But as a portable game, it's kind of cool because it's like, okay, here, you beat the game, but here, there's still a bunch of stuff to do, and that's kind of cool, right? I mean, if I had this as a handheld game, and it was pretty cool like that.
Right.
But from like a Let's Play standpoint, or from I want the story but I don't want to go through all the missions, it's a fucking nightmare. This is 12 minutes. Took me about 6 hours of grinding out side ops and doing outer ops and all sorts of stuff like that.
Just to get good shit.
Well, not just to get good shit, but just a part of the prerequisites for him escaping is you completing certain side ops and completing certain outer ops, which is the stuff where you dispatch your guys. Oh, look at him hiding on the wall, little bitch. Dumb.
Whore.
But So that's all of Act 5, and then you get to the true ending of the game, which I can't wait to show you because it's a fucking anime music video in the middle of it. They're playing, they play J-pop in it. I told you about that, right?
No, you didn't.
Oh, it's great.
You don't even know about Miku, come on.
I know what fucking Miku is. You're gonna love it.
I am gonna love it.
So if you notice, it's just the doorknob over and over and over and over, and that's just because I cut out all the side ops. God, it's been to pull back the curtain from your eye sheepskin,
sheepskin
or something.
Condoms.
It's been It's been months since we did the last recording, because college is a fucking
bitch.
Whore. Actually, that's fine. I just did a bunch of college algebra before...
Go fuck yourself. You gotta go do math and shit. I gotta go do science. I'm the science guy.
You're gonna have to do math. You're still gonna have to do all
fuck
your...
Fuck off! I know.
So if you're watching this, obviously we're basically cutting between five fucking Zadornov missions. And if you watch the gameplay progression as we go on through this part here, you're gonna see that I did this over the course of an evening in like an 8-hour spat. And
There's a guy.
You can see my play style devolving over the course of this, to the point where I'm just shooting people in the fucking stomach with my shotgun by the end of it. So, I mean,
up again. Fuck you, you motherfucker.
This is one of those things, if you play the game for the story, right? If you play the game for the story, then this whole Act 5 nonsense is kind of a fucking pain in the ass. It's a real chore. But if you bought it as a game and you genuinely enjoy the gameplay, then getting to the end of the story, getting to the true finale of the game is no problem. And it's actually kind of important that you do if you're trying to play through the whole thing, because a lot of Ground Zeroes and the Phantom Pain, the next two games in the series, aren't going to make sense if you haven't seen the finale of this. Like, they explain it away a little bit just to kind of give you an idea, but you don't really know too much of what's going on.
Right.
Because Ground Zeroes is going to revolve around two characters here, one of them being Chica. Oh, hey, look, I've been seen. So what do? Kung Fu!
Gachapa!
Jiu-Jitsu! Face kick! Roundhouse! Roadhouse.
Boot to face.
But actually, Act 5, if you approach it as just kind of like, not necessarily a greatest hits, but it pulls you through a lot of the game. You actually go through the majority of the environments in the first part of the game, going through all the Zadornov missions, and that's kind of cool, which actually culminates in the last one. Being like the very, very kind of beginning of the game if you played a lot of the side ops and stuff like that. But it's cool to see. It's cool to see, and it's, yeah, boners. I don't know.
Fucking midgets and the marble-laid shit-face-ass mother donkey-punching son of a bitch.
So,
what the hell?
Yeah, Kung Fu.
Fucking glitch.
So, enlighten me. I know you haven't played this game. I know you haven't played 2. You haven't played Ground Zeroes or the Phantom Pain, right?
Correct.
But through osmosis and the general internet, you know a lot of the story beats, right?
There's a lot of donkeys, apparently.
Do you know a lot of the story beats, a lot of the twists and everything?
Nanomachines and whatnot, right?
Well, I mean, that's way, way later, but I'm talking about in the next couple games here. Because obviously, you know the twist at the end of this because I've kind of told it to you, but I haven't...
I've forgotten it.
...completely given it away. But, like, you're not up to snuff on Ground Zeroes and the Phantom Pain, right?
Correct.
Okay, so it's going to be important for you to pay attention to this end part here.
What the hell?
Because it's going to set up a lot. You didn't see that? Oh, you never played the original Metal Gear Solid either. That joke won't make sense to you. It's a reference to Metal Gear Solid, the 1998 PlayStation game.
Oh, I see.
So this motherfucker's hiding in trucks. He's hiding up against walls. He's a little some bitch.
Yeah, he's a little bitch.
Apparently in Mother Russia, hide and seek, play you. I am Zangief. I don't fucking know it.
Fuck you, Zangief is cool. This guy is a bitch.
Yeah. They both start with Z, though.
Speeded muscle.
Big Boss doesn't even believe him anymore. He's like, you're bullshit.
Who the fuck needs a fire? Hey, I think he needs to guard him himself.
Yeah.
All this shit.
He's too busy womanizing. I was reading up on Kaz on the wiki, and apparently he spent the entirety of this game just
going on dates with her.
Having super fucks with all the female staff on Militaire Sans Frontier.
You can't fault the man for that. He wants to get his dick wet.
I was in the wiki and they were referencing some like non-canon shit out of a book, and apparently, like, Miller started, like, sleeping with people's wives and, like, public songs and shit.
What?
Yeah.
Wow.
And it's this super surreal, weird fucking thing to read up, because it's like he's doing soap play with Armadillo's wife, Puma or something like that. Because, you know, they all get the weird animal code names in this. And so like, an armadillo fainted, even though he is strong like bull or something. So here's the part where I just start saying, fuck it, I'm tired, and just shooting people in the stomach. Dead.
Dead.
Him dead. Still grabbing guys, though. Hey, remember when
that haven't died.
Remember when I shot you in the fucking stomach? Oh, yeah, by the way, he's hiding in a love box.
This motherfucker.
He's trying to pull a snake, but he's not good because he picked, you know, the box that stood out.
His shit.
Oh, my God. Yay.
Hey, go by my crotch.
We did it again. So there's number six, and the video is going to end after the intro to number seven, and then we're going to, you know, cut back to the actual finale here.
Bullshit.
But yeah, so several hours of going through side missions and stuff like that. It's cool. It's part of the lore of Big Boss is Big Boss doing all these crazy military ops, right? So the fact that it happens, it has a purpose in the story, but if you just want to sit down and have them talk story at you, it's not what you're looking for. And that's going to play into that. That idea is going to play a lot into the story of the Phantom Pain. And I will go over that once you get to the big twists in the Phantom Pain and stuff like that. Once we get to that game's big reveals and stuff like that.
The reveal!
Yep. So that's the end of that. We will see you guys in a second here. Woo!
Bye!
Well.
Son of a bitch.
Well.
You're like getting flashbacks to fucking Devil May Cry.
Here we are.
Uh-huh.
At the finale.
Uh-huh.
This fucking game.
Uh-huh.
I'm not actually that pissed about it. I'm happy to be moving on to bigger and better things because I've been doing, like, video checks and shit for the next games in the series, and I'm so ready to play that shit. Oh, okay. So, Zadornov has escaped for the final fucking time, and now we need to go find his ass. And the interesting thing about it is they always gave you an idea. They always gave you a mission area and said he's there, go fucking look for him, right? But right. This one, they say, we have no fucking idea where he is. Well, he's on Mother Base.
Uh-huh.
So let's go to fucking Mother Base.
You have to look for him on Mother Base.
Commencing target practice, yep.
Wow.
But it's not like Phantom Pain, where you actually can go around all of Mother Base. Here, it's just Mother Base. It's just fucking Mother Base.
Well, it's because it's a PSP and not a fucking PlayStation 4.
Apparently, I can't bring a supply marker on this mission, but fuck it, who cares?
Fuck it.
So let's start it. So we have to go somewhere on Mother Base, and that means we have to go to one of these target practice missions, because that's the only time you actually get to physically walk around Mother Base. Why do I have this rocket? Because we're going to fight
fucking
Zadornov.
Freedom.
I picked the wrong mission. Fuck. Wait.
God. Fucking damn it, you piece of shit.
I very well may have picked the wrong mission.
I hope you did. Because now this Let's Play can be canceled.
Let's go. Let's Play canceled. Fuck. Anus. Shit. Well, this is gonna get... Yep.
Training exercise. Ha! It was the wrong one. You piece of shit.
No wonder they call you the boss. You climbed that ladder. Oh my god.
Fucking minigun attached to a lamb, piece of shit.
I fucking fucked that one right up, didn't I?
Yeah, a little bit.
No, I don't want to save. Yes, I want to proceed without saving the game. Okay.
Yeah.
Now let's really finish the game. I think I might have to pick the first one. I might have to. Fuck it. Let's try. I'm pretty sure it's the first one. I'm pretty sure because it's the actual shooting range.
My attention is waning like my wang.
As a special treat,
yep.
You can share some of the female members of Mother Base with me, boss.
Oh my god!
I'm never gonna get over the fact that he's a giant fucking womanizer. Also, he's gonna reveal some shit at the beginning of Phantom Pain that kind of puts a big twist on what the fuck was going on this entire fucking game.
Spoilers.
You don't know it.
Kazura is a goddamn womanizer.
Yeah, well, okay. Yeah, that's absolutely a spoiler. Here, you
but
know,
this is the last episode.
Instead of actually, hey, look, who the fuck is up there? Hey.
That son of a bitch!
Hey, should I shoot him with a rocket? No, because that'd probably end up with, like, a game over or some shit. So
really?
Let's slowly plot our fat asses up here. Be like, hey, 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 yo, asshole. So here we go. We find Zadornov again, and this triggers the actual finale of this fucking game.
Okay.
Which you know nothing about except what I've told you. Also, I have an M16 suddenly.
Then shut up so I can hear.
You can't hear? The shit's turned down all the way. You gotta read the subtitles.
You're dead, bitch.
We put one in his ass.
Right in the dick.
Right in the dick, girl.
What are you talking about?
Yeah, what are you talking about? What the fuck?
Rocket. Oh! 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 Rocket fist!
Nice. Evade. Oh, what? Look at this anime bullshit. Look at this shit.
Yes.
What the fuck?
Oh, I was waiting for you to give a more hype reaction to the Rocket Fist.
God damn.
So fuck you for not being excited about Rocket Fist.
Oh, well, I knew about it in fucking V.
Okay. Shut up.
I've seen it.
Shut up.
I've seen it.
Shut up. Stop giving shit away.
What's going on? But I've seen it.
Snake is the Shagohod.
Let's play canceled.
Fucking shit. Fucking. So we just killed the
you
fuck
see that
out of
all
him.
The time in hentai. You see the V, the double Vs.
Oh, yeah. Oh, my God. Okay, this is turning out pretty well. It's a giant fucking shit show, and it's going to become even more of one here.
Oh, yeah?
What would you do if I told you we're not actually recording video?
I'd fucking let's play cancel.
Oh my god, it's Zeke!
You have to fight Zeke?
Yeah!
Wait, so you build this motherfucker up from the ground up.
Yup.
Steal parts. And now you gotta fucking destroy it?
Yup.
What the fuck?
Hey, look.
Oh, you little piece of shit!
It's Paz.
You fucking concubine, fucking little shit.
My name stands for peace.
Whoa! She's fucking almost naked. What the shit?
She's
I'd
wearing.
Stick it in her butt.
No. She's 16.
I'd tongue punch her fart box.
It might be legal in Tejas, where you are. In Tejas.
Hey, remember, they're in international water, so it's pretty much legal.
You're not wrong.
Ow!
You're not fucking wrong.
Look at this shit. Oh! It is anime bullshit.
Oh, yeah.
She's made some mods.
So, basically, this thing was designed to be controlled by an AI, but
yeah.
She has modified it so that she can actually pilot the thing, which is kind of a huge deal.
Bitch, you don't have enough badges to control me.
That, is that a fucking Pokemon? Oh,
look at that booty! Yeah, it was.
We are a bunch of misogynist fucking assholes.
That's the most roundest booty I've seen since Metal Gear Solid 4. Yeah, I'm talking about Snake's butt. That's man's butt.
Okay, stop talking about men and things that happen in the future. Nothing has happened yet. We don't know what's going on.
Hey, girl.
All we have is our past and the here and now. So basically,
hey, girl.
She's been working for Cypher, for Zero.
Hey, girl, what that mouth do? Let me knock that bottom out.
So basically, if you were totally into wanting to hit that, you now find out that she's not some 16-year-old fucking chick. She just looks 16, so...
Yep.
So,
I knew it all along.
Boss smash!
Dude, her eyes look a little fucking cockeyed.
Yeah, that's the Peace Walker shit.
Wow. Fuck her right in the pussy!
Oh, come on! This is a wholesome channel...
Oh, wait, you're serious. Let me laugh even harder. Oh, shit.
Way to blow out fucking RIP headphone.
Oh, fuck.
Sounds like all that cum's finally getting to you.
Woo! Fuck. like.
So she's basically setting the stage for the future here, but the gist of it is that Zero doesn't like the fact that Snake went off and did his own thing, and they're both trying to create the world that the boss wanted.
Okay.
And Zero's approaching it from one way, and Big Boss is approaching it from another way, which he doesn't know it yet. Because he still hasn't resolved himself to that.
So does he do that during this battle?
Okay, why do we have X-ray vision on the boobs?
Whoa!
Why do we have X-ray vision on the boobs?
Damn.
Hey, can you hold down the LP for about 7.5 minutes?
No! I like that's where we both win.
No, you can't.
We both went there.
No. Look at that anime face.
It's like Zone of the Enders.
Okay.
Hold on. No, the real question I want to fucking know right now is why the fuck is she in bra and panties right now?
It's a swimsuit, and there's a reason for that. But you brought up Zone of the Enders. You know they're the same universe, right? You know eventually, like 150 years down the road from fucking Metal Gear Solid 4.
You have like Egypt fucking like machines and shit.
You've never seen either of those games, have you?
Which one?
Zone of the Enders?
All I know is it's like based off like Egyptian mythology or some bullshit.
It's not really, some of the mech designs are, but it's the best action game on the PlayStation 2, period. The second one is.
Well, God of War is up there.
No, you haven't.
Go fuck yourself. I love the fucking God of War.
You know, I've never played a single God of War.
Well, I've never played a single Zone of the Enders. We should,
We need to correct this.
Snowball this shit.
We need to have dueling Let's Plays where we split the camera down the middle, and whoever's game is more hype slowly takes up more and more of the screen.
Wait, what the fuck is going on right now? Are they going into some, like, some Evangelion LCL bullshit?
Kind of.
Oh my god, she is! Man, it's fucking anime bullshit! What the fuck?
Apparently, the difference part of is she's being fucking able to control naked. Zeke is you have to be submerged in the cockpit.
Well, I just fucking came all over this shit.
That water is delicious. Congratulations. We've talked about cum a lot in the first 15 minutes of this fucking video.
We've mentioned it twice.
We've mentioned it 45 times.
Twice, and we've mentioned the act of masturbation.
So this is the big twist. This is the big plot dump. This is the, hey, this is really what's going on, shit going on here.
Right.
Yeah. So the entire game was pretty much a prelude to this moment. It was all set up by Cypher and Zero. Which is kind of a big deal.
So you mean to tell me she doesn't get oxygen supplied directly to her bloodstream via liquid?
No.
She actually has to have like some kind of scuba gear.
Yeah, so it has something to do with pressure. It has something to do with like the pressurization of the cockpit, I guess.
What a crock of shit.
Well, I mean, I guess.
Fucking anime bullshit.
What are you gonna do?
Come on, Kojima, get your shit together!
To be continued in the next mission, we're going right into this shit. We're going right into this shit. This is gonna be like a 45-minute episode, so,
fucking do it!
Yeah, girl. Fuck it. Yeah, we'll save really quick. Now that we've gone through the process. So this boss fight that's coming up is actually really, 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 really fucking cool. Because not only do you get to fight it like you've been fighting the other mecha in the game.
Put it in her butt.
No. Not only do you get to fight it like the other mecha in the game. Zeke is currently away on assignment with an Outer Ops team. We just looked at it! That is inconsistent with the lore!
Continuity fucking issues.
Oh my god. Okay, that fucking took me out of the moment. So I have to go up here to Outer fucking Ops. I have to go to Dispatch. I have to pick a team, and I have to take Zeke off the team, even though Zeke is standing directly in front of me with a sexy little, like, 20-something sex girl fucking about to fuck up my shit.
I put it in her butt.
God damn it.
I want to put it in her butt.
I can't believe that. That's fucking... Okay, let's see. Mission prep. I've got all my shit. I do want to grab my supply marker here. Stop it!
What?
Stop jerking it.
You can't tell me what to do.
This is
don't
not
you tell me how to live
moment.
My life!
Okay, so this... Now that we're actually getting into the boss fight, this is actually a really, really cool boss fight. Because not only do we get to fight this fucking thing the way we fight normal mecha, we get to fight it with parts of Mother Base.
Nice!
Yeah,
that's kind of cool.
Yeah, it'll jump to like different platforms and shit. You can launch anti-air missiles at it.
Hey,
you, can drop...
you know who else does that?
What?
God of War.
Oh, God in your war.
War in your god.
Oh.
Oh.
Oh, the implications of it are mind-boggling.
Oh, God.
So this is actually, this not boss fight can actually be some serious business. I remember the first time I did it, yep. It was kind of a big fucking deal. Also, you notice Zeke isn't complete. I didn't get all the parts. Like, I didn't get the extra armor. I didn't get the ray dome. And it's got the jump jets and the rail cannon, obviously, but it needs those in order to operate. Oop, that one.
Oh,
high.
God. Missile locked on. Oh, shit.
Actually,
oh,
it's,
shit.
It's firing at me with the, yeah.
That's kind of cool.
Oh, I got it. Yeah. Okay. So I come over here, and I'm pressing in a thing for airstrike. Oh, shit. Oh, I did it too late.
Shoot it in the crotch.
No, it's trying to shoot me from its own crotch. Okay, there we go. It's running over there. Okay. Can I press it again?
Get back here. Pause. I'm going to fuck you in the ass.
Use. Oh, I have to be up against the wall.
Oh! You okay. Got 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. Do it again. Here it comes.
Oh, I'm screwing this. Oh!
Oh, no! Oh, fucking Let's Play canceled.
No, shit's bad. Shit's happening in my house. It's shooting me from its peak. Oh,
oh!
Shoot me in the face. I'm dying.
Fucking right in a goddamn fucking kisser.
So you're supposed to go up against the wall and then target it like that, and then you're supposed to hit the button, and then that calls in. Oh God! Oh jeez! Oh God!
Oh,
and then that's yeah. Okay. So I'm
fucking
calling
health.
In, I called
fucking
in,
health.
I called in airstrikes on the fucking thing, and now it's actually down. So let's try this again. Oh.
Uh-huh.
Oh.
This is so underwhelming.
This. I'm sorry. Okay. You can't hear. Ah! You can't hear the Vocaloid track, so of course it's underwhelming for
it's
you.
It's actually voiced by a
Zeke's getting distracted
Japanese
by
voice.
Gun platforms. Now your chance to ass hack. Look at it kind of running around. It's actually... This was one of my favorite fights in the Gizame.
Oh, yeah?
At one point, yeah.
I hate to break it to you, but this was sung by Paz's voice, Japanese voice actors.
No kidding.
Yeah, it sits so right.
Okay,
like,
so look, now it's gonna launch more missiles at it, and it's shooting.
More missiles!
Look at that, they're dropping in shit for me. Not
oh
that
God.
I'm gonna be able to get to it. So yeah, this
what
is part
fuck?
Of the cool. fucking skating
fucking
around and shit. Part of the cool thing about this boss battle is that. It's just. Like, Kojima knows it's a fucking anime.
Right into it.
Hide! Okay.
Push the button! Push the button!
I gotta get over there!
Oh,
to push.
You gotta...
No! 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 The side!
The side!
Shit's going down! Oh shit, the target.
The eighth member of the Cobra Ops. The side!
The chocolate.
Oh, it's lifting his leg up.
I can't. I'm trying to.
Oh god. Where'd it go? There it is. Do it.
It's not like I'm not like. Come on, you fucking shit!
Oh!
Did I die?
Yeah.
How did I die? I had all the rations in the world. Fucking, this is gonna be an hour-long episode. Shit.
God.
Okay, well now you have the idea of the thing, so now you can talk while I concentrate.
Let's play canceled. See, look right there. Japanese voice, Nana Mitsuki.
Okay, fine.
But, I wish it was sung by Miku. I fucking take it.
Specifica Ocean is all like, we don't need peace. I like turtles. I wish I had a dash. I wish I had a sprint. I wish I I wish I had fucking something.
I wish I had lambs with fucking anti-ship cannons attached to the backs. So, like, not feasible, but it's cute.
I wish I could Fulton sheep.
You'll get your fucking chance to do that soon.
So, I didn't really mention it in the little montage thing we did, but there's actually some really cool side ops that you get to do, or extra ops, or whatever the fuck it's called, that you get to do in the
deck,
including fighting ghosts and all sorts of shit like that. I do not actually need to heal right now, because I am... just clipped through the thing. Well, there's your immersion-shattering moment. Shit. Immersion-shattering moment right there.
Yeah, not to mention your aim!
You get to fight ghosts. You get to do cool gimmick missions.
Yep.
You get to do all sorts of cool stuff.
Right in the butt.
And it culminates in this big-ass boss fight battle. There we go. Slowly doing it. So much of this mission just turns into just dump on her. That it can kind of be underwhelming, but the actual fight and knowing it's the end, along with fucking come on, knowing it's the end along with the
gonna shoot you.
I'm trying to. I don't think it can. Oh shit! It's shooting missiles at me. It can totally get me.
Fire a rocket!
I'm forgetting. I also totally have chapter. Pretty sure they do crazy
stuff like
look at redirect. It.
It's dancing around
the AI
like it
can't
doesn't...
handle it. She's screaming at it. It's totally it's dancing to the music.
It's white girl wasted. Oh shit. Hit it.
I'm attempting.
Fucking do it.
I'm pressing the butane. Hide. Oh god. So there was a missile fired. Oh yeah.
Oh,
she's
pissed
off now. So we got her down to what, 60%? The cannon's taking a beating. Okay, cool. So the cannon's fucked up. I think that this boss battle, follows the same principle as the other boss battles, where if you destroy pieces of it, it won't be able to use like a special shit.
Yeah, but you're not collecting it, right? You're not collecting because this is yours.
Yeah, you're not really collecting it at this point, but, like, I can stop it from doing its dumb skating shit. I think if I knock out the rocket boosters.
Run away! Run, bitch! Get some help!
Oh, shit, you're right. I need some health. No, that's the wrong one. Curry, the good curry. Throw the
Eat
chafe.
It. Oh, God!
I can't stop chafing.
Oh, hey.
Dance for me, you sexy bitch.
Dance. Everything's going to be daijobu.
I don't understand what that means.
It means okay.
I feel like Nicolas Cage in a commercial.
I feel like
those
fucking commercials, dude. They're funnier than the Arnold commercials.
So, oh god, oh
Explain.
God, oh jeez, Cheez-Its!
Cheese and rice.
Oh wow, I've got her down to below half her health.
Ba-boom!
I got so much shit in my shit!
She's right on your ass!
She's
going to fuck your ass!
She's
going
to
give you the wet work!
She's going to tit fuck her ass!
Shit.
If y'all don't
shit,
know what we're doing, we're doing Tourette's Guy. Can we make the rest of this episode just a Tourette's Guy themed episode? Ass!
Fuck salt!
Sounds like
what are you talking about, kid? That's just intern! Oh no! Dude, you are getting fucking wrecked!
Shut your fucking whore mouth. It's fine. Wait, I killed her
Run.
Cannon. Why is she using. No! It's busted. It's fucking broken.
No, all she said it was taking a beating. That's all it was.
Oh, I'll give her a beating.
I will too.
Alright, you
Double
ready
team.
For this?
I feel
yeah!
Let's do
yeah,
this.
Rocket!
Boom!
Tune,
got one more!
Tune the stink!
Tune the stink! Give it a fucking three-finger salute! Shock.
She's down. This is it. It's over. It's over.
Fuck
it's
her right
over.
In the pussy!
God, the RPG fire is so fucking slow. God damn it! You fucking bitch!
Just die!
Oh, yeah! There it is.
Brick squad!
Brick squad.
Brick squad. Brick squad.
So that was fucking Peace Walker and shit. Yay, yay.
Yay.
I'm so hype about some shit I'm not actually particularly that hype about.
Right.
I'm hype about what's fucking coming up. That's for goddamn sure. For shizzle-bizzle, my bizzle-nizzle.
Fucking fuck her right in the pussy.
Oh, I don't think it's going to happen at that point. Look at her dumb steampunk goggles.
Are you serious?
They're not really steampunk, but she's wearing goggles so she can see the displays and shit.
Fuck is wrong with her arm?
Listen to me, big boss. What was wrong with her arm? I didn't see
it. I don't know. It looked like it was cut off.
No.
It looked like she was an amputee.
No.
I'd still fuck her.
Is that what... Is that... Does that do it for you?
Huh?
This fucking Let's Play... That's so
bad. Off the rails. Let's Play canceled. Oh, fuck her dead body. Hey, fuck her while she's still warm.
It's... Oh. It's gone off the rails and right into the amputee ward and the morgue.
And necrophilia. I was going to say zoophilia, but hey.
No.
Whatever.
No, Snake Chan. Not my Kitsune Ni-chan.
Put it right in the pooper.
Right in the pooper. So I think we have to sit through another fucking credit sequence again here. That's one of the things I didn't like about these games. Is there's a credit sequence after every fucking mission. I mean, not every mission in this, but you beat the game the first time and then you get the credit sequence. And then you beat the game the second time and you get the credit sequence. And
have you heard about Metal Gear Solid 4?
Yeah. Yeah, I've heard of it. I heard it has the Lord of the Rings thing. I got an S rank on that.
And you still got fucking...
I S-ranked
you
that
still
mostly
got ranked.
Naked little Colombian girl.
Delicious.
Oh, God.
Her tits were perfect, and she had the roundest ass.
So, Huey...
Fuck you, Huey, you piece of shit!
Yeah.
Hope you fucking die!
Huey's kind of a turd. He seems cool at this point, but... The, now my word! Oh, God! Oh, continue the Let's Play! Oh, do it! Oh, God!
Everything's gone to shit now. Look at this motherfucker. You fucking pussy ass, bitch ass. Look.
Oh.
Fucking bullshit.
Oh,
hey.
Jesus.
I hope you got it on your laptop and everything fucking dies.
Electrocution.
I wish that wouldn't happen because we'd have to do this all over again. Huey, you fucking piece of shit.
Jesus.
You probably eat. You'd probably drink milk when you eat pizza, you piece of fucking shit. I'll fucking murder you. What the fuck's going on? All I see is this fucking mammal bullshit. This bitch. This fucking bitch. Put it right in her pooper. The fuck? Is that Huey? Don't look like Huey. Looks
it's
like
totally
Huey. It looks like a combination of Huey and Abraham Lincoln.
Fourscore and 7 years ago, we made sick fucking Mecca and used it to fight the fucking Russians.
you saw what I was talking about, though, right? The thing around his chin looked like it was fucking magical, just majestic Odin's type, like, fucking beard that he had.
Crisis.
He doesn't have a beard because he's a fucking pussy.
Crisis averted.
Where's
my Nam? I cleaned up.
Fuck you!
I cleaned up water. I'm in the wing. Where's my Nam?
You don't get one. You suck.
Shit. That's pretty much how it went down, too.
Yeah.
God damn it. Okay, anyways, so I'm back.
No.
So that was Peace Walker. So I'm going to ask you questions so that we can talk about the shit. What do we know at the end of Peace Walker? Or what do we know up to this point?
I don't fucking know. I wasn't paying attention. Paz is hot and she died.
You really haven't been paying attention?
I think I'm fucking with you. I don't know.
Okay. So...
We averted a war. No, we're supposed to... No. Fuck.
We averted a war. Snake has his own PMC and he's been doing crazy shit with it, right?
Yes.
But what do we know? What do we know about Cypher?
They're a bunch of assholes trying to come against. They're trying to fuck up Snake.
Well, you saw the idea behind that fight, right? The whole entire...
What the fuck?
Yeah.
Hold on.
There's a lighter in the finger. The whole reason... I'll let you get to your point in a second. The whole reason that Poss did that was Zeke, and the fact that it was a nuclear-equipped weapon and she had it was supposed to be a bargaining chip to get Snake to be Zero's army, Cypher's army, basically. And now that we know that, Snake is kind of pissed off.
Hear me out, okay?
Because he knows this whole fucking thing was part of Cypher's plan.
Motherfuckers.
Right?
Those sons of bitches.
So look, Kaz knew who the fuck they were. He knew they were with Cypher.
This motherfucker knew?
Yes, Kaz has been working for Cypher. So you already know that Kaz is more or less not entirely on the level at this point.
Fucking triple agent.
If you actually read into Kaz's backstory, he never considered himself... up until probably this point, he never really considered himself an ally of Big Boss. They were in some shithole Central American country, and they were both, Snake and he were both parts of opposing PMCs, and he had basically had a Japanese fucking samurai mentality of, like, even though Snake beat the shit out of him on multiple occasions, both physically and, you know, his PMC beating the other PMC.
He put it in his butt.
Even though Snake beat him on multiple occasions, he would never surrender. In fact, at one point, he even asked Snake to be his second for his seppuku.
Seppuku?
Yeah.
Oh, the observer.
The guy that chops the head off, basically, since Snake was the victor. So Miller, Kazuhiro Miller, has always had his own fucking agenda in all of this.
Yeah. Probably the same thing in V.
No, actually. In V, he's genuine as fuck. In V, he's genuine as fuck, but up to this point. In fact, V is the turning point. V is the point where he's like, Boss, I'm with you. Fuck everything. And I'm not going to go into the reasons why that happens, because we're going to see it in the next few episodes of The Recollection here. But
amputee. What?
I didn't hear what you said. Anyway, so these guys are talking about what the fuck's going on. They're talking about where their place is in the world at this point. And Big Boss is basically saying, look, fuck anybody who's opposed to our shit. He will fight anybody who tries to basically restore the old system of the philosophers, etc. Which is what Zero's doing with Cypher and eventually the Patriots.
We are going to be fighting the biggest. That son of a bitch, Zero.
Well,
he should be a good guy too.
These games have this overriding idea behind it, and it all comes down to the boss's philosophy. That there's never such thing as a true timeless enemy. Right?
Muslims.
What? Oh, come on. There's never such thing as a true timeless enemy. And if you think about it, at this point, Snake with his private military company and Zero, both trying to pursue the boss's idea of a unified world, are two sides of the same coin. So you can never truly hate the guy. You can never truly hate Zero or Cypher for what it is. Now, they give you some fucking antagonistic motherfuckers throughout the course of the series, one of the best coming up shortly. But they're always, like, on the level of, like, cartoon supervillains.
It's anime bullshit.
Yeah. But, no, at this point, we know that Snake has now resolved himself to try to execute the boss's will and unify the world through his own means, which is his private military corporation and his actions. And Zero is trying to actually physically unify the world through spy espionage shit. And we didn't actually get the codec call. We didn't actually get the codec call in Metal Gear Solid 3, where he starts talking about James Bond for 20 minutes. But Zero is a huge, huge, like, spy fiction nerd. So half of Cypher and half of all the shit that's going on that's this, like, weird spy shit is because he's totally a fucking...
Zero loves the spy shit, so
yeah,
he's trying to
Zero's
act
a
it out.
Fucking spy otaku. So we get one of these timeline things. We get one of these timeline things at the end of every game. And they change at the end of every game based on the revelations we get in other games that happen chronologically in the series. Millinator, is it Millinator?
Oh my god! Keep it!
I am the Millinator.
Keep it!
I am here to fuck your wives.
Dude, that was awesome. What happened to Miller?
Come with me if you want to come. No, it said he's assassinated. Don't worry about that. That's a plot point from a different game. Which is one of the things I was kind of worried about playing these games out of chronological order and playing them in the order of the actual timeline is right. That you get a bunch of shit spoiled for you. Right?
Huh.
You get a bunch of shit spoiled for you, but I wanted this to be a chronological beginning to end. You know what I mean? I wanted
wanted to be the story instead of the games, the physical games.
Exactly. And I wanted it to be that way so that you had a foundation for all the shit that's going on, and I wanted the people who may or may not watch this I wanted them to see it from the origin to the conclusion. So that you have a big picture. Because I think overall, that's more important to the appreciation of the story than having all these crazy twists happening in every game that that put a spin on shit that happens in the future. Because up until Metal Gear Solid 3, all the games happened according to the timeline. Metal Gear happened in 95, and then Metal Gear 2 happened after that. Then Metal Gear Solid, then Metal Gear 2. And then Metal Gear Solid 3 came along and introduced us to the origins of the series. They gave us Big Boss's backstory. And I said it in the previous Let's Play we did. I said it in the very first Let's Play we did of Metal Gear Solid 3.
Right.
But it was my thought at the time that Kojima wrote so much crazy bullshit into 2, because so much crazy, like universe-warping shit happens in 2, that I'm sitting here thinking, okay, he wrote himself into a corner, and so
he really didn't do that.
And so he's now going back 70 years in the timeline in order to give himself a basis to continue the fucking story. And honestly, he kind of did, and that kind of fucking...
Vocaloid!
That kind of fucking happened, because a lot of things that happen in 4 wouldn't make sense if you didn't play 3. Some of the characters in 4, you would have no fucking idea what's going on if you didn't play 3. Like, you wouldn't know who some of the characters are.
And you're completely right, because I played 3 and then I played 4 and I knew almost exactly what was going on.
Exactly. And that's one of the reasons I did it this way. But I feel like if you're a fan of Metal Gear Solid, or if you're a fan of the Metal Gear series as a whole,
Metal Gear,
you will not be watching this. Or if you're trying to get into it, you will not be watching this at this point. You'll see the first game, say, that's fucking cool, I want to check them out, and then hopefully you'll check them out in the order they were released, or something like that. Hopefully you'll check out the PlayStation Metal Gear Solid first.
So what are you saying? So are you saying that if you're a fan of Metal Gear, you need to watch them in actual chronological order, or are you saying that they need to watch it in the story? The story's chronological order.
I'm saying the true fans, and I'm not trying to discount anybody who, like, from this point, from the point of hearing my words, on pick up this series and plays it. The true fans, I think, are the ones that have been playing this since day one, or whatever day one was for them. If they were 12 and their parents got them a PlayStation 2 and then they picked up Metal Gear Solid 2 and they said, oh my god, this is the fucking best shit ever, and then went and checked out all the other stuff. I consider those people the true fans, and the true fans will have experienced all those twists in the order that they were presented to them in the first place. So basically, if you play Metal Gear Solid 1, and then there's a revelation about that game in Metal Gear Solid 3, and you experienced it that way, that's cool. That's how you experience those twists. But you don't need to experience them that way to become a fan of this series. Which is why when I decided to throw everything together, or to throw this recollection together, to start from the very beginning, so that you have the story, not the twists. But then you can see the twists when they happen. So, for instance, not too much happens here in Peace Walker. There's actually some very interesting tapes that I'm going to release along with this episode as like a companion episode that flesh out a lot of the shit that was going on with the boss up until Snake Eater.
Oh, Snake Eater.
I will release those as a companion piece, but at this point, what will happen is there was some revelation that happened in like this game or Metal Gear Solid 3 Snake Eater, and it basically explained something that went unexplained in a game that'll happen later on. And when they bring that shit up in those later games, I'm gonna recall you back to this, and I'm gonna say, "Hey Tony, remember back in Peace Walker when this happened?" And you're gonna go, "Oh."
I probably will.
Because it's almost like you're experiencing these for the first time. Because, yeah, you're going to get the gist of the story from doing these Let's Plays like this, but you're not going to remember everything like if you played the game for the first time. Or you're not going to remember everything verbatim like I do, because I've played all these games 1,000 fucking times. Final Stinger, right, by the way, coming up right here.
Stinger?
Yeah.
Isn't the missile?
Shut up. There's always
get the fucking pause while she's still warm.
There's always a big fucking plot twist at the end of this. But anyways, yeah, no, doing these Let's Plays like this, you don't remember, especially by the time the fucking episodes come out, you don't remember what the fuck happened. So we're gonna get two games where there's these big twists that were explained by previous games,
right?
And I'm gonna bring that up to you, and you're gonna go, "Whoa, man!
Whoa, dude!
Yeah, pretty
nar nar,
pretty much." And so essentially, even though you have the background, you will still be experiencing it for the first time, which I think will be cool for you, and that's part of the reason I wanted you to come along, because I know you only played like two of these games.
Yep. 3 and 4.
Yep. So you have a lot of crazy cool shit coming up in front of you, sir, and hopefully the people that are watching this will appreciate it as much as I'm thinking that you will.
They better.
Because like I said...
Or I'll be under their fucking beds.
Oh my god. Like I said at the very beginning of this entire series, this is also Big Boss just saying, "Look, I got a big dick. I will fuck with anybody."
I got the money. But I got the power. Fuck with me.
God damn you. What I said to you at the very beginning of this entire series in Metal Gear Solid 3, Metal Gear Recollection, episode fucking 1, is I said... This fucking game, this game is basically a fucking anime, and so the story beats are going to be anime-ish.
Anime!
So get ready for a crazy ride. We've got so much more coming up. Thanks, guys, for watching.
Yep.
Ground Zeroes is coming up next, so hopefully you guys will still be sticking around for then.
That'll be short.
Bye, buddy!